What's happening, guys, and welcome back to Missahippy Plays Blood Bowl. I'm Missahippy, and I've been invited to play in the Dwarfhead Cup. My first opponent is the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. We're going to check them out. They're running undead, two zombies, two mummies, I mean, two brights, three ghouls. That's a lot. That's going to be fast, faster than me. And four zombies. My team is Nurgle, because Nurgles are fun. We've got three Nurgle warriors. Well, it's gone. But we're running three Nurgle warriors, one Prestigore. We've got our Beast of Nurgle, and three rerolls. The rest is Rotters. So, let's see what's going on. I don't think I saw any rights on his team. I don't even know if they have... Yeah, the undead has rights. By the way, I am playing Ill Repute. Give a shout out to him. He's been very patient while we organize this game around my schedule. So, good on you, mate. Connection was opponent was lost and regained. And we're here to start the match, which is good. I'll go ahead and press to skip this, and so is he. Alright, he gets the first choice. Yeah, he's got two rights. Alright, so he's put his zombies up front before kicking off. Okay, so I'm going first. So he hasn't rearranged yet. So, what we're going to do... By the way, this is two-minute turns. The first time I have ever done two-minute turns. So, we'll see how this goes. We're going to bring that rotter up on the line. And we're going to push him a little bit further back over here. That rotter's going up on the line. Same thing with him. A little further back over here. We're going to put him dead in the middle there. Bring him and him up one. And we'll put our Prestigore over here, actually. And what to do with this one? Whoops. Let's go ahead and move him over here. Fantastic. And we're ready to go. So we're going to accept. And he went ahead and put his right on the line. Which is good. We're going to press his G so we can see what's going on. He's got his zombies right on the line. Moving his right up there. He's got more block than me because of these guys. None of my guys really have block. That's going to be a good thing. I've got about the only thing that can punch his mummies right here. So. That'll do. He's got his rights out, but this isn't much of a passy team. If he wasn't so strong with the two strength five zombies, I might even have put my Nurgle warriors up there instead of those rotters. But as it stands, we're going to do that. Interesting little clump of runners back here. And he's going just straight up bashy. Everyone on the line. Everyone on the line. And he's left my guy open. In the middle here, which is interesting. All right, let's go ahead and kick it off. So we're just going to kick it right there. All right, Blitz. Fantastic. So So we're going to start off with a GL and an HF. And we're going to get to work. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to move this rotter right here. Then we're going to blitz Mr. Grabby there. We're going to move him into here. Actually, we're going to blitz him. All right. Moving that zombie back. Yep. Fantastic. Now let's move him into defensive range. Very good. Now with that said, we're going to move him up into the face. There we go. Good in the face. And of course, he's coming to be his companion. Moving to the right. We don't want to overcommit too much, so we're going to leave a couple back. But we are going to move this guy into this box. And we're going to run our Prestigore here in the middle so that he can handle it. And probably move our right here. Fantastic. End of event. Press escape to get rid of that. And scattered into his territory, which is kind of what I was worried about, but oh well. He had to go for it anyway. And escape again so that I can see what's going on. Which that's the exact reason I didn't overcommit over here. I left a couple back. Take care of it. I left him off just so he could handle it. He's going to base me with a zombie, which I can get out of if I need to. He is in range of that, so he's going to run by, but unless he can get that right around, I can get in on him kind of quickly. I've got two, my Rotter and my Prestigore are in line for that. And I think he's going to try to move the right. On me. Because he hasn't moved him yet. Yeah, he's going to blitz that with the right. Okay. I might have tried to use him to defend, but it's all right. Burning rerolls, which is always a good thing. And he's pulling him there for a base, which may or may not work. We'll see. So, we're going to stand him up. And we're going to stand him up for sure. Alright, so, first things first, let's do this two-die block. Fantastic, yes. Alright, start with a knockout is always a good thing. Now, we're going to run him over here, I think, in my way. He's not really in his tackle zone, so let's actually pull him a little ways back in case of an emergency here. Then this one, we need to knock this guy out. Yep. And also this one here. We'll push him to here. And yeah, we'll go ahead and follow him. All right. Now we're going to be moving these guys to counter. If necessary, that zombie is very slow. So we don't have much threat out of him. So let's go ahead and go for that two die block. And it's a push, unfortunately. So yeah, let's not waste a reroll on that. We do have a guy on him. Either one of these places is acceptable or not. Yeah, go right ahead. Can anyone else move to help defend? Brave Zombie Dodge, one of two reasons for this team is being the other mummy. Oop, I was busy reading and my time expired. Ghouls are fast as well. Alright, he's got block, so there goes him down. Good dice, good dice. Good dice, good dice. Like he can just run around. How far can he get? To there, so he can't get out of range, luckily. Oh, but he can do that. Make a cage, make a cage. All right, I see ya. I don't know if I can stop him from scoring. I can still get in front of it, but... not by much and not very hard. So I can blitz this guy on the end for a one die. That he can do that though. My turn? Alright, let's get started. First thing, he goes up. Second thing, he goes up. He's gonna walk right here. And this gentleman is going to move over here, hopefully. Fantastic. Now, so we're gonna move this guy the long way around here. And then one GFI. Fantastic. Now my Prestigore can dodge out and try to block, but that's not safe. So instead, we're going to run this guy right over here. And then we're going to put a two die block on Mr. Zombie here. And we absolutely want to follow him. Then we're going to use punchy here. Nope. Free that right up. Nope. Now, last ditch, which is being our most risky, dodging here and putting another tackle zone. And putting our guy into surf territory, which is going to be bad, but it's all we can do. So there we go. We've built kind of an anti-cage here. He's got to run out and around, and that's going to put him in range of the big nasty. I've based his right. His guy here is free to move. To apply an assist if need be. But it is turn three and he is deep in my territory. This could not be a good thing. This is not where I want to be. So he's obviously going to surf my Prestigore though, which is very bad. And I shouldn't have done that. But, you know, hindsight and all that. I was just trying to get him into the fray. And actually get a tackle zone on the ball. Alright, he's got a two die block there. Question is, does he move forward into my range? Yes, he does. I actually think that might help a little bit, just depending on what he does with the ball. That doesn't, though, so he's going to come blitz with him. No. No. Interesting. Give the ball to him and have him run it in. Good game. Nothing much I can do there. I mean, I'm sure there's something I could have done, and I'm sure you'll let me know. But, yeah, I didn't see it at the time, and that's what matters. On the bright side, he scored in three turns, so that leaves me a few. To get it back. So let's let him set up. That's not entirely, I guess. I might have surfed the Prestigore, but still. But I'm bloodthirsty. That was more proper than what I would have done. Because I would have surfed the Prestigore. Alright, so we're receiving now. And we've got tackle zones on all of these guys, right? Right. So we are head up and down okay there. We're gonna put us a rotter here, right up base, since he wants to, and we get the first move. And actually, because we have the strength advantage, why not put one there as well? Same thing over here. Trade it with a rotter. It's going to go here. And then we're going to put our Prestigore back with another rotter. We're going to put him back here somewhere. And you, sir, are going to be the babysitter. It's a very important job. So, you babysit. And accept. So, I didn't leave enough people free to really make a functional cage. Okay, so quick snap. So at least the events are going my way, but where is the ball going? There's nothing, like there's no, where's the indicator? Do I not see it? Is it off out of the way? Oh, I'm gonna give it where, so I'm hoping this means that the ball is going away. So that means I'm gonna run him forward. I'm going to move him here. He's going to go back and to the right. Because I feel like the right side is my side. So, end of event. Yep, it went out. So, we're going to give the ball to him. Ta-da! Very first play. We're going to punch him. And that's not going to do. Let's use a reroll. Oh, loner. Bad show. Well, let's at least do a both down. Maybe my mighty blow will help me. Bad luck. And I burned a reroll for nothing, which isn't very good for me. I forgot that was a loner. So silly. So now you're going to tromp that zombie to base my... No? Yeah, okay. Punch me. On the left side. Let's... Where's the blitz at? I heard it, but I didn't see it. Am I? Yep. I left him free, but you don't have any real spare movement, do you? No. I'm gonna run away from you, silly. Better yet. Nope, you're in another player's tackle zone. Push. And he doesn't follow, which frees him up for that. Block, which is fantastic for him. Oh, and a stun. That's very good. I'm in bad shape here. And now he can just go down the line. There is an opening, though, and I don't know how exactly we're going to take advantage of it, but we are. Actually, no, because that zombie wakes up next turn. So, what would be the point of that? Like 21 dice rolls there, look, no doubt. But if you think I'm going to let you do this, then you're wrong. So, all right, time's running out. We're running out of movement time here. So let's figure out what we're going to do. Let's stand you up, which should give me not what I needed. So I'm gonna have to use my blitz here, which sucks. All right. Not re-rolling a really stupid for anything though, so let's go ahead and knock you back. Yep. And double one. I get to get hit by a zombie. This is bad. What can I do? What can I do? What can I do? Not a lot. He can kind of go out of it, but what is he gonna do but get hit? This guy has a movement of four, right? Yeah, so I'm in his range, but not well, and he'd have to dodge, so that's okay. I've got kind of a screen here against him, but as far as this guy here, I'm not sure about. So, also, not going well at all. And he blocked himself there. So he has to run the long way around to get to me with this guy, which he might be able to. Maybe. Him focus on that, though. How far can he run? Not far enough. Oh, good basing. He's can't believe he didn't blitz him though. As that guy slowly rolls closer to me. It's all right though, I'm gonna roll out of his reach next turn. I hate to use my blitz on that. But he's gonna make me. All right, so first thing, who's got you here? Oh, this guy. Okay. One die block, one die block, one die block. Two die block to start off. Let's go ahead and push them back. Yeah, follow him. All right. Why is that a one die? In what sense is that a one die? I see. So if we stand him up, it won't be a one die. Apparently, it will be. Now I'm really confused. I'm strength five. He's strength five. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do is obviously. We're gonna figure out how to run away with the ball. It should be a two die block with a dodge if I can get him up, which I can't. So I'm gonna have to dodge with the Prestigore, and that's all there is to it. Yep. Ah, and I'm out of rerolls. Had to, though. Didn't have another plan. Man, I really would like just to toss that ball that Prestigore now. It seemed like a bad idea earlier, but kind of looks better. Oh, he's gonna grab it and score on me again. I see it coming. This could go badly quickly. And he's gonna surf my rotter to a much lesser extent. That's much worse. All right. Nope. He's going to use a reroll. And God. Good scatter. I mean, I could put a ball on it, but it's not gonna stay. I can put a body on the ball, but it's not gonna stay. I can't even manage to pick my guys up half the time. Why would you? I'd have tried with him, but think he could have run in. Maybe he's moved already and I didn't realize it. Yep, surf. That would have happened. All right, so I'm at no rerolls and I'm trying to keep. Ah! A lot of you are going to be like, that was frustration. There are other plays I should have done first. Nah. What I roll? I rolled a two. There's not much that a first roll of a two would have changed in this situation. So he's going to run in score, as he should. Fantastic. Of course, this is why I bring Nurgle into a league. But it's okay. I ain't sweating it. Keep your mind down. Try to get stuff ready. Do, 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 do. We'll get back to you on that. If you watch this, the answer is I was thinking about the ball. So, do, 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 do. I see no reason to change this. At all, actually, yeah. Do, we'll do that. And then, yeah. Except. So let's see what happens. Oh, yeah, he's deciding where to kick it. All right, so first thing, let's get old dude on that ball. That is by no means the most important thing. Pardon me. So, first thing we're going to do is this block. Push him here, and that's a no. Nope. All right. That's a no. Now I can hit this one with a 2-die block or that one with a 1-die block. He's still at a -2 because that 1-die block is still a thing. And there's really no way around that. So, what if I blitzed? He'd be a 1-die block. But I'd use my blitz. But he's in range of the ball carrier. So, that's a 1-die block as well. So, let's do it for the lulz. And my dice rolls suck. All right. I don't know why you put him there, but how'd he get a 2-die? He was covered. She wasn't covered. No, she was covered because he was there, but by no one else. Oh yeah, he went down. Add another guy. Who are you going to blitz him to? Shifting. Boom, 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 boom. My turn. So let's do this. Shutting down all that. Shutting down all that. We're gonna keep you there for the fun of it. Shutting down all that. You're going to step up in that, and you're going to go up here. Oh, come on. Hurt him. Then that is the end of half of very bad rolls. Granted, they were bad decisions, but the bad decisions were always preceded by bad rolls. All right. Let's get ready for a better half. I get the ball, so. I don't know why these guys were they knocked out? I never saw them knocked out. Oh. All right, my turn. So, he's rolling on this. He's leaving my left side kind of way open. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this rotter right here. Rotter. I don't have enough rotters. Wait a minute. Why are my guys stunned? Okay, screw that. So back to here with you. Have you right here and you right here. Then I'm gonna put you and you up. You. And then accept. Sweltering heat. Forgot about that. He's answering my questions. Right, so where is the ball going? On their side of the pitch. So. This router's gonna go to block. I can hit him with him, and that'll leave me to hit him with him. And yeah, all right. That'll free up him at least. All right, good, good, good. Let's end this event. Fantastic. So, nope, that was. Very bad. Very, very bad. All right. That kind of screwed up my entire game plan. Isn't terribly shocking, because my entire game plan was thin from the get. So I've only got three openings here. Can you make it to there? You can. So we're going to bring you right up here, base it there. Oh, that's a one die block. You can get around that pretty good. So we're going to put him right there and do this little half cage because we are not forgetting our fundamentals. Nope. So what I need to do to run him right here, right? No. They have negative two die blocks. Just to give me a chance at a one die block to free him up. So instead, let's take the risk where it belongs and not blitz. Come on. Ran out of time. Oh well. See what he's doing. He's probably going to punch my... Yep. So I was about to say, punch them in the face. I totally would. Right, now he's going to box in on my cage. There's his blitz, which is just a push, which is really good for me. He's going to get a thing on the ball carrier. But it's just a push, and I can knock him back next turn. My main problem is I only have two warriors left, and they are... buggered. He has really neutralized my strength advantage well with his two fives. I don't know if it was advantage. We're kind of even. He had two fives. I had three fours and a five. So take it how you will. But so the first thing we're going to do is punch him in the face. Oh my god! Dead? What did that say? Casualty dead. Dead! Fucking dead. Woo-hoo. Dead. At least it was only a rotter. Ooh, pardon me, folks. Trying to get over a cold here, but Jesus. I cannot roll to save my life. I'm not going to get any SPP from this. By damn, I will. That's him knocking him over, I think. Yep. Which gives him one die block on my ball carrier here. I'm not getting any SPP from this at all. None. I haven't hurt anybody. Not gonna score. Nope. Not gonna score. Now it's official. Just don't catch the ball. Or you catch the ball, because, you know, whatever. Alright, so what needs to be done here is I don't even freaking know. I'll be damned if I let you score with a zombie, though. I know that above all else. So, you want to go ahead and surf me with your ball carrier? You're welcome to. Personally, I think that would be a rather bad decision. So, I've got to make a one die block, which is scary as hell considering. First thing, we're going to stand big guy up here. Thank you. And we're going to run this other big guy. Try to get him into a little bit better position. Right. Stand this guy up so he can get punched down again. And then... Thank you! Yes, follow. Which will leave me open for the blitz here. Do I want to be in the middle of that? I really don't. Yay, someone gets SPP. Yep, that was expected. Now they're gonna punch. Yeah, foul appearance works. And the ball scatters. Do 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 do. No. No, you shall not. Okay. All right. Thrown together. So he knocked down him. He's got him bunched up. The blitz with that big mamma jamma. That is cool. Question is, can either of you two gentlemen get on his corner? Yes, you can. Back to the dice logs for all that you've missed. Can't believe he's not going to try to grab it. Find that odd, but what the hey? Oh, and of course. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to run this gentleman, because this gentleman can make it. Yeah. So I can screw up everything right here, or I could get a good hit. Oh, yes. Come on. Keep fucking with me. Come on. Oh. Yep, just go ahead. Nobody cares. That sounded rude. He's gonna watch this. It's not rude, it's. I really don't. Okay, so he's gonna give it to his faster thing. Clean handoff. I just want my dice to work, really. That's at heart. I want to roll better than that. And I get it, it's a loner. Your rerolls don't work sometimes, but sometimes they do. I'm just saying. Okay, he's just gonna do that. And that's my phone. You know, that happens sometimes. So let's stand this guy up, and that eludes all of his extra stuff. And then moving this guy right here. And then trying again. That is fine. Nope, don't want to follow. All right, so let's stand him up. Very good. Yep, give him a follow. Very good. And we're gonna move him over here, kind of bait-ish stuff. Nuffle giveth, and Nuffle taketh away. Puts him with the big dude. I got no one to cover him. So, oh yeah, I do. Well, no, not really. Damn it. So I might as well ignore the big dude. You've already blitzed, so you're good. Okay. Possible plays, diagnosing. Well, I got one. Is he gonna pass now? Yep. All right, so we do this first, and we follow. Yep. Next, we're gonna use this guy to base this dude. La da da da. Then we're gonna stand this guy up and punch this guy in the face with a one die block and nothing, cause I can't roll a one die block. Do 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 do. Yeah. He picks up the ball and scores again on turn 15. And I don't blame him, because I would take the SPP too in a heartbeat. Maybe someone important will get MVP. That's all I can hope for at this point. Like my Prestigore. That would level him up. He's the only person done anything. Oh. Are you going to go for the pass? Okay. Pickup failed. All right, he got stunned. So that's a no-go for him. All right, so. No! Oh, God! Oh, that is a horrible place for that button. And that's the end of our first game in the Dwarfhead Cup. Oh, God, it's going to be a long road with Nurgle. What a fitting end indeed, my friend. Who got my MVP? The Mystics Game Rotter. No. Oh, it's so horrible. Oh, it's so horrible. The Mystics Game Rotter. I don't even remember having a Mystics Game Rotter. I remember having a Dead Rotter. And he's gonna get fired because he's got a niggling. Oh, next. So let's go ahead and tell this guy GG. And we're gonna take a look at our managed team. Managed team. Alright, so who's got a niggling injury? Like, I don't see a niggling injury, and no one on my team has, this doesn't make any sense. 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh yeah, it's gotta be confirmed and all that. Okay. Well, I will see you guys next time on Miss Hippy Plays Blood Bowl. See you guys later. Peace.